Let's have a look at tuples. Now, tuples are also lists of values, but instead of being enclosed in square brackets, they are closed in parentheses. So these normal round brackets. Now, tuples can be heterogeneous. In other words, you'll see here I've put the numerical values, integer values 1, 2, 3 in here, and a string, hello. But what they are is they are immutable. Immutable means they cannot be changed once they have been created. So you have created the computer variable called TUP, and once I've created that, it cannot be changed. I cannot change a value as I could with arrays, and that's one of the big differences between arrays and tuples. Let's run this code, and we see our tuple there, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and the word hello. Just to make sure, the type of it, it is a tuple. And it found a 64-bit integer, a 64-bit integer, another 64-bit integer. That would be the 1, 2, 3, and then an ASCII string. Now, we can look up the value and the type of each element. So let's go for I in 1 to the length of tuple, so we can still, the elements can still be counted. We're going to print new lines for each time there's this for loop. And we're going to print out to the screen the value of the tuple at index number. Now, $i, because the first time we're going to be at index 1, the next time the for loop runs, it's in index 2, the next one. And then we're going to use this tuple, and in square brackets, it's index value. So that would be exactly the same as arrays. They are still really just indexed starting from 1. And then we're just going to use the type of what that tuple index, or at least the value at that index is going to be. So quite a simple for loop there. And we clearly see the value of the tuple at index number 1 is 1, and the type is 64-bit integer. Until we get to index number 4, and the value is hello, and the type is an ASCII string. Now, another difference is we can actually name these indices. Now, let's just run that. Let me just show you what I mean. Now, we have the values 1, 3, 5, 7. You see that I have enclosed them in parentheses, so this is going to be a tuple. There are 4 tuples, and I've given each of them a name. So in index position number 1, we have the value 1, and I'm calling it A. So A is going to equal 1, B is going to equal 3, C is going to equal 5, and the word 7, which is just a normal computer variable, is going to be the number 7. So we run that line of code. Now I can say for I in each of A, B, C, 7. So that actually is just an array of all of these names, these computer variables that hold these indexed values in the tuple for me, and I can print them. And there we see the values 1, 3, 5, and 7. Now tuples can also be sliced. So if I have tuple 2 here with all of these values, we just run that, there is our values, and we can use the index keyword end. So what would be the last element? We can slice it from number 2 to number 4. So index 2 would be the 3, index 3 would be the 5, index number 4 would hold the value 7. I can also reverse the order, all these kind of things that we just did with arrays. So end in steps of negative 1 to the first index, so that's just going to reverse the order for me. But remember, they are immutable, so I can't use something like tuple 2 here, TUP2, index number 1, I'm going to set that to the value 5. That is going to give you this set index, has no method matching set index error here. So you can't do that. You cannot change it while once it has been created. Now the next thing just to remember, something else about tuples, I can have these tuples inside of tuples. So there's a tuple 1, 2, 3 inside of its parentheses, but that is just one of some other tuples. So it's a tuples of tuples, and you can see them there. At index number 1, though, of tuple 3 is that whole tuple 1, 2, 3. It makes up that whole index at index number 1. But I can, well, what you would see then, this 1, 2, 3 would be index number 1, the 1 would be index 2, the 2 would be index 3, and 4 would be this index. But it has a sub-index. So if I say TUP 3, 4, index 4, that would be this 3101. And from there, I want index 2. So what we do is we have these two sets of square brackets, just the order in which it follows, and that is going to give us the value 100. I think that's about enough for of tuples. In the next lesson, next section on this lesson, we are going to have a look at dictionaries.